Hi, how you doing? I'm your host, Rich, and we have a Rich TV Live with our very special guest, the core contributor for Axion Network, Joel Gerlach. How you doing today, Joel?
Hey, good. Thanks for having me on the channel.
Excited to have you on the show. Excited to learn more about Axion Network. Joel, tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got involved with the Axion Network.
Yeah, so my name is Joel. I spent about 10 years working in the Hollywood industry. I worked on a bunch of Marvel movies and stuff like that as a visual effects producer. That was kind of my background, was working in the film industry, and then discovered crypto, discovered the pacing of it, the intensity of it, and was like, oh, this is awesome. I can use some of my talents in film industry in creating and visualizing concepts and communicating to people, and completely stumbled by accident into the crypto world. And now it's my full-time job and I love it. I'm really excited.
Yeah. You know, I love cryptocurrencies as well. And I kind of stumbled into it too. I think that's how everybody got into it.
I think so. Totally.
And you know, you just fall into love with it because you see all the potential, mm-hmm. see all the upside. It's super exciting. Can you tell us what are some of the milestones that Axion Network hit this year? And what are some of the things investors have to look forward to in 2022?
Yeah. So just a top level overview, Axion is building a staking ecosystem. That is what we're doing. So you've seen a lot of other staking tokens where you take the native token, you stake it for a period of time, you get your rewards back. What we're doing is we're building a staking ecosystem. It's almost like a club that gets unlocked for you when you stake your tokens. And that's really what we've been doing. So Axion's over a year old now. We were on the Ethereum blockchain for about a year. And then we switched over to Polygon. We actually did an entire migration, moved millions of dollars in Bitcoin and millions of dollars in Ethereum entirely over to Polygon, where now our most expensive transaction is pennies or several hundredths of a penny. It's amazing. We love Polygon. But it is, it's a token where you are a project where you take your tokens, you stake them. And then as a part of that staking, you get access to really a much broader ecosystem. One of the things that has made us famous for the time that we were on Ethereum was when you stake your tokens, you get a fixed rate APR, which is awesome. So it's not fluctuating. It's always guaranteed. It's 8% up to 45%.
Wow.
And that is our maximum for when you're staking at the longest duration. But then also you get Bitcoin dividends. And that is really cool. So basically you're able to receive passive income off of your stake without affecting your principal, which is great. So and the cool thing is that those Bitcoin dividends are, there's no minimum amount and there's no minimum term for you to qualify. So you can be earning that passive income. It's a great way to dollar cost average into Bitcoin because it happens automatically. So as Bitcoin fluctuates, you're getting that DCA into Bitcoin automatically. And then we've got a huge bunch of stuff in the ecosystem that happened as we launched on Polygon. NFTs are a really big thing for us. We have one of the coolest things is, you know, NFTs can be artistic and they can provide some utility. For us, it's utility first. So the first thing is we have four different classes of NFTs that are available. One of the things that we just launched literally yesterday was the Axion Collider. So when you bid into our accelerator, which we talk about in a second, or buy into our accelerator, buy Axion through the Axion accelerator, then what happens is you get a particles NFT. And this NFT is guaranteed every single time that you buy it, shows up in your wallet, it shows up on our staking portal. And what happens is you can take that NFT and you can enter it into our collider and you get a chance to earn bonus Axion up to 10x of the original amount that you put in. And what's cool is that it auto stakes that for you. So you take your NFT, you enter it in the collider, and then you can choose the duration that you want to stake if the collision is successful, the particle collision is successful. And then it stakes it, which means it's earning Bitcoin dividends. It's allowing you to participate in Axion launch and voting, all that sort of stuff. So that's really cool. That literally just launched yesterday. Another big thing coming up on our roadmap is NFT stakes. So we're the first staking project out there in the crypto world that's going to allow you to take your stake, the actual stake data that you have, and mint it as an NFT. We have, just for our community, we built a procedural animated galaxy generator. So every time you take your NFT, it takes the data from your NFT, the length, the term, all these different variables, and it uses it in the process of generating that galaxy that's unique to your NFT. So it's just cool. It doesn't really do anything other than look really cool. But what you'll be able to do is you'll be able to, when we open up our NFT marketplace, you'll be able to buy and sell other people's stakes, meaning that the value that they assign Just like selling an NFT on OpenSea or something like that, the value that they assign to that stake is now going to be purchasable for someone else, including all the future Bitcoin dividends that it'll get, the APR that's locked in, the global share rate, all that sort of stuff, which means that there will become a marketplace for people who have stakes. You'll be able to, in a sense, buy out somebody else's stake and be able to earn interest on it and be able to earn those passive Bitcoin dividends. So it's really cool. That's just around the corner for us. And we've got so much more also just around the corner. There's a lot going on in Axion.
Yeah, so excited. You're blowing my mind right now.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
So exciting. I love how cryptocurrencies and blockchain technology is changing the world. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you mentioned staking, you mentioned dividends. Traditional banks are in some serious trouble. You guys are definitely bringing a lot to the table. And let's talk about this. So, Joel, mm-hmm. can you tell us about the team at Axion Network and especially their past success in the crypto markets?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we have a world-class team, literally worldwide. We have people wow. on the contributing team from all over the world. We have the core contributor team is made up of 6 different people, all coming from different crypto backgrounds, people who've been involved with centralized exchanges, decentralized exchanges, who've been involved with marketing other crypto projects. We have a 24/7 moderator team, which is really cool. You can go to our website and there's a little help icon in the bottom corner and you can click on it and chat with somebody from the support team at any time who can answer any questions that you have about Axion or even crypto in general. And then we also have the Axion Advisory Council. What we did is we actually brought on people from all over the world in different industries. We have a businessman in India. We've got a guy from Africa who's growing his crypto following. We've got a US Olympian athlete. We've got the owner of a AAA production studio in France, all these different people coming in. And what they're doing is they're advising on Axion and helping us making sure that we're behaving ethically, making sure that we're behaving in a way that benefits investors, making sure we're operating in a way that is true to the long-term vision of the project. And the cool thing is everybody involved on this project 100% came from within the community. We all started as investors. We all saw the potential for Axion to be something amazing. And all of us have added in areas of expertise. And then we work together. The cool thing is that we have a voting system that's built in to our platform where you take your stakes. The actual stake that you have is a validator for your ability to vote. So stakes with 1 year and over are able to participate in these community votes, which allow us to direct the project. It's kind of like a DAO. It's not a full DAO because the way we describe it is team-led, community-driven. So there is a team. The team is providing leadership, creating new implementations, doing things like marketing and advertising, oversight, all that sort of stuff. But then the community gets to vote and we get to verify that those votes are true and are in the best interests of the long-term community. One thing that we didn't talk about is that right now, actually, let me look at the statistics as it is today, because it actually just changed. I was very surprised when I saw it this morning. It's gone up. Oh, yeah. So right now, of our total supply, 73% of our total supply is staked, which is amazing. And we have a crypto first, 46% of total supply has been locked away for 15 years. That's our max stake. It's 5555 days, 15.22 years. And 46% of it is untouchable for 15 years, which is crazy. That sort of bullish long-term behavior makes us a really unique project, because most yield farming, most staking projects are looking within the couple of months, right, to even a year. I mean, a year in crypto is crazy. So to think
it's
about
like an eternity.
For us, it is.
That's a year in crypto is an eternity.
A year in crypto is the entire world could completely change. So 15x, that is insane. Yes. But it shows really the long-term staying power of people believing that Axion is going to be not only around in 15 years, but also that they're going to be getting a great ROI in that entire time, because they're earning that solid 8% and they're earning Bitcoin dividends the entire time. And with the Collider and the Accelerator, all of that stuff is working to build an ecosystem that's really functioning and running on itself. And with Polygon, I mean, in Ethereum, it costs people about $200 to $300, right, to get in the accelerator, because the gas prices were so high. And right now we have a faucet, so you can fill up, you can use Matic, the Matic that we give you to bid in the accelerator for free. And even if you don't use the faucet, it's still right now, just yesterday we were doing it, it costs 1 penny to bid in the accelerator. So that means all of your principal can go towards actually investing and not having to pay fees. Sorry, I totally drifted off your question.
That's okay. Sorry. No, that was good. You hit the point. Now, you also recently announced that you launched Luxy, the mm-hmm. next generation NFT marketplace. Can you tell us what that means for the project and how big the NFT marketplace has gotten in trading volume?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is a really cool thing about Axion, because we have investors who are looking at the long term, right? 46% locked away for 15 years. That means our community has kind of pre-vetted itself to be people who are looking for long-term growth, long-term projects, that sort of stuff. So for us, as I mentioned at the beginning, kind of like a club, Axion is a really unique marketplace. We have 20,000 wallets. And of that, we have almost 6,000 wallets that are staked max. That is the perfect community for a token launchpad to want to have. They want people who are looking at the long-term benefits and who aren't just going to get an airdrop or participate in an IDO, wait for it to 10x, and then immediately sell, right? So what we're doing is we're using our reputation to go to these other projects, or actually all of these other projects are coming to us and they're saying, hey, we want to do a launch with your community. And we're able to then work hand in hand with those launch partners to get them a really solid, really amazing, really vibrant community. And these people are the kinds of people that are perfect, right? So with Luxy, this is something that we just announced. It's actually going live on November 22nd, and it's $100,000 allocation, meaning that you get to participate in, and we think it's going to go really fast, because what Luxy is taking the OpenSea model and making it so much more vibrant, so much more easily accessible, cross-chain built in automatically to transfer NFTs between chains. If you look at like OpenSea's volume in 2017, it was $400,000 in the first year of its existence total. And then in the first 6 months in 2021, it's over $1 billion in volume. I mean, it's absolutely huge. So to be able to get in on a really well designed, really intuitive, easily accessible. I mean, they allow stuff like setting royalties to 100%. So you could have an entirely charity driven NFT where every time it gets sold, 100% of those proceeds go towards whatever wallet you set, like a charity recipient or something. These sort of things are just taking the OpenSea model and really innovating on it. And we believe that through our exclusive allocation on Axion, that people are going to get into Luxy, and it's going to be like buying IDO tokens on OpenSea. So it's really cool. We've done a couple other partnerships. We've done about 6 or 7 launches so far, just in about the 6 months, about one a month that we've been doing. And the cool thing is, like, Vabel is one. It's the next generation of Netflix. It's built on the blockchain. And we did an IDO, we did an airdrop. People got airdropped tokens that about 3 months later were worth about $5,000. They just got it, right?
For free.
Literally, it was the airdrop. It was an initial allocation. People got it. People still holding on to it. It's worth about $5,000 now. So, you know, token launch partners want to work with Axion because our community, I mean, the cool thing, like with Vabel, we check in with them and we found the vast majority of the wallets that we assigned to their IDO, IEO, and airdrop have not sold their tokens yet, because people are holding on to this and believing in the long-term vision. And that's something that's really cool that we can offer. So something like Axion Launch, you can only participate if you are in 1 year, if you have a stake for at least 1 million Axion, which right now is like about $200 or $300, and that's staked for 1 year. So again, and that's how also we do voting validation as well. And it's just a cool way for us to bring people in, allow them to be a part of our ecosystem for a longer term, and then they get access to this really cool stuff.
I love what you guys are doing. You guys built a strong community, mm-hmm. and now you're using your community to help other communities grow.
Exactly.
Brilliant. And using a long-term approach, a long-term investor approach, and showing other projects, hey, look, we've got long-term investors here. We can help you get long-term investors, so you're not going to have that churn and burn, pump and dump type feel in your project, because we don't have that in our project. I think it's brilliant what you guys
are doing. It's really cool. It's really cool.
You know, as a guy who also is building a community, I understand how hard it is to build a community, maintain a community, grow a community, keep your community happy, keeping them winning, keeping them vibrant. So I think you guys are doing a great job. Now, that leads me to my next question. If Axion Network were to compare itself to its competitors in this sector, what would you say set you guys apart?
Yeah, a lot of, I mean, the kind of joke we say on the inside is we're trying to make yield farming look boring, right? By comparison. And that is really kind of our ethos. So when you look at a lot of different staking tokens, you know, Hex is a big one, Wise is another big one. They're spread across a bunch of different networks. What they do is they do one thing, and that is you stake your tokens and then you get that APR, that APY, and then you kind of that's about it. What we're doing is we're offering, I mean, what sets us apart, of course, is the Bitcoin dividends that are liquid. You can withdraw them at any time. You can spend them. You can reinvest them if you want, which allows you to compound. All these staking tokens don't do compound interest. You earn, you know, usually fixed rate or whatever's coming in. What we do is we allow you to take your Bitcoin dividends, enter them into our accelerator without having to withdraw them first. So it saves you on gas. And basically it allows you to reinvest and compound your dividend into more Axiom, which gives you more of the share pool, which gives you more dividends. That's a pretty cool way to kind of reinvest what you've been earning. Or you can take it out. You can spend it. You can do whatever you want to do with it. So just immediately, the Bitcoin dividend sends us apart. Voting sets us apart, right? Using the stakes as voting is a big thing that other tokens aren't doing. We've got a huge feature that we released right on our Polygon launch, and that is stake splitting. This is the first time a crypto project has ever done this. And this is where you can take your stake and you can split it by percentage. So you can do 40% on one side, 60% on the other. Well, why would you want to do that? The cool thing is you can take, let's say, that 40% stake and you want to upgrade it to the max, to that 5555 day stake length, then you can earn the biggest share of the Bitcoin dividends pool, all that sort of stuff. And then you want to take your other stake and let's say you want to mint that as an NFT and then you want to sell it on the market. Or let's say it's, you know, a year from now, Axion is massively appreciated, the price is 10x, whatever, and you want to take it out. And let's say you have a 5-year stake or something like that. With other projects, you know, with staking, if it's a fixed term, if you withdraw early, you get penalized, right? That is present in Axion, that's present in all these stakes, right? You set a term, you say, I'm going to lock my tokens away for this length. And that's your contract, right? You're entering into that contract. But what you can do with stake splitting is you can shave off some of the top of your stake, right? Early withdraw it, which means you get penalized, but you're not losing the entire stake, right? The whole thing isn't disappearing. So functions kind of like that also distinguish us, because we're all investors. We all came from the community. This is the sort of things we want. And so this is the sort of stuff we build into the project. You know, we also have stake naming, where your names are stored on the blockchain, which is really cool. The NFT stakes is a really big deal. No other, there are other staking tokens that are talking about NFT stakes, but we're literally like a couple of days away from launching ours. And the marketplace is going to come with probably about 30 to 45 days ish afterwards, just because we want to make sure everything is working, make sure it's all good. People can mint their stakes, all that sort of stuff. Another cool thing that we have is you can transfer your stakes when you mint them as an NFT. So once you mint it, you have a window. Let's say you created stakes on a software wallet and you want to transfer them to a hardware wallet. Well, now you can do that. Where the other projects, they're locked onto that wallet address, right? You can't change them. So we've got a world-class team. I mean, it's really amazing. We've been audited 4 times by top auditing partners. All of the audits are publicly visible on our website. Axion V3 code, which we just launched when we came to Polygon, did a complete line-by-line audit by Hacken, and it came completely through. So we know that the stuff we're building in is secure, it's solid, it's a good long-term investment for people, and these features completely set us apart. I mean, people look at Hex, right? Hex is such everything that's good for Hex is good for these staking projects, and just seeing what they're doing with Pulse and all those things is really cool. It's great that there is somebody taking really that initiative and showing the power of what a staking token can do. And so for us in our community, it's kind of like getting in on Hex back when it was small, and being able to have all these additional features added on top of it. And so really there is that, there's a lot of power there for people to come in and to not just see stuff on the roadmap that's upcoming. You know, maybe these features will get added someday. They're already here. They're already a part of our ecosystem. And there's more being launched every month. We've got more stuff. So we think it's a really cool opportunity, and we hope that, you know, people really like it.
Yeah. I mean, so far I love everything I hear. Now, we here at Rich TV Live, our investors are really fundamental investors. They love to understand the coin economics. Can you go through the coin economics of Axion Network for our viewers and how you plan on attracting more institutional investors alongside more retail investors?
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the cool things about what we do is I mentioned the accelerator, and the accelerator is the economic engine behind Axion. And what that means is when you buy, so right now to answer a question I'm sure you're going to ask in a minute is how do people get involved, right? Axion is on Polygon and you can buy Axion tokens through SushiSwap. And we have centralized exchange on the roadmap. And it's actually pretty close to being, we wanted to work with a centralized exchange that can connect with Polygon. Obviously that's an important part for us. And that kind of changed since we moved from Ethereum. But one of the things that is very important is what are the economics, right, behind Axion, and how is this a stable long-term? A lot of staking tokens, what they do is they know that inflation is kind of a big deal, but they set that problem aside. And inflation has to be combated, right? Every time you use something like an auction system, that was kind of what Hex did, you have that inflation, those tokens are being minted. So what does the accelerator do that's different? So the accelerator, the Axion accelerator available through our staking portal is the best way to buy Axion, because what it does is it gives you a bonus. You get 1% bonus on your principal per year, and then a bonus on shares up to 300% bonus if you stake max, which is why a lot of people are staking max, because they have that huge share bonus. And so what's happening is in the accelerator, when you buy Axion, you take whatever coin that you're bringing into the Polygon network and you bring it into the accelerator, it allows you to buy and stake in one transaction, which sets us apart. Other tokens, you have to go buy them on your DEX or your centralized exchange, bring them to there, and then you stake them. For us, you can buy and stake in one process. We have fiat on-ramp coming shortly. We'll be able to use a debit card, credit card, a bank account to immediately buy in Axion into the accelerator and stake it, which is really cool. It's another thing that's important for us. But what is happening behind the scenes, and this is why we're working to be a deflationary token. And that is, it's going and it's taking a large percentage of the incoming allocation. 55% of it is actually going out to SushiSwap, and it's buying Axion off of it, which is great, creates that positive buy pressure. But then it's also taking and it's locking away. It's our kind of burn mechanic. It's our, those tokens are being sent to the Polygon debt address, where they'll never come back into the circulation. They're still there. You can go see them. They're not being destroyed. They're just being sent to the Polygon debt address. And because of that, like I'm just looking at our metrics here. Since we started the accelerator, which was August 16th, we've burned 16 billion Axion, which is about $1.7 million worth of Axion through the accelerator, which is great. We're taking up all that stuff that's being sent to the market, and we're automatically kind of taking it away. The rest of it's going towards Bitcoin dividends, which is what is distributed to our community as a portion of the share pool. And then about a small percentage of that is also going to support Axion Development Foundation. So which is cool as a project. We don't have to use our dev wallet to sell tokens. We can actually fund our operations, our overhead, the server costs, all those sort of things through the accelerator and other additional methods that we got, like selling some NFTs and those sort of things. So we're working as a company to be to not have to rely on using our token, right, or selling on our investors, because we're all investors. We all want to see this project thrive. And so with that, kind of the way that we're deflating is helping us combat the sort of typical inflationary things that happen. Another thing is that with penalties, instead of distributing penalties to stakers like some other projects do, those penalties also get sent to the debt address. So that means that every time somebody early unstakes, instead of that Axion being sent out, it is being removed from the supply. I mean, it's not technically removed from the supply. It's still there. It's just nobody's ever going to be able to spend it, right? And so kind of what that just means is that we are we're working to be a project that has that long-term staying power. And that's important, right, as our economics. The cool thing is if you go to our white paper is actually just about to be updated. It's a little bit old. It still talks about Ethereum, for example. But you can see we have two world-class mathematicians who actually built the economic model. And you can see the calculus, the actual calculus equations on our white paper for how the economic model is built and how it runs. For the math nerds, I'm not a math nerd. I don't understand it. But that level of transparency, right, we can actually read the fundamentals of the project and how it works is really cool. So I'm so sorry. I talk so much.
Oh, it's okay. I just You're love excited. This project. You're excited about the project. And
yeah.
And I love it that you were, you know, an investor and now you're part of the company. So they're taking people that are part of the community and they're promoting them from within.
Yeah.
I think that's brilliant. It's kind of the same model that I use with my business. I think it's the best way to do it, as opposed to bringing people from the outside that maybe don't really understand your business as much. Mm-hmm. So In saying that, if there was one thing that you would want people, investors, to know about the Axion network today, what would that be?
There's a lot of people who believe in this project. As you can see with that 46% staked max, I mean, that's just people are voting with their tokens. You know, these are tokens that were bought in the accelerator, tokens that were bought on SushiSwap. People know they can't just take their tokens back. Those tokens being locked away shows that there is something special about Axion. Our Discord community is vibrant. There's people in there all the time. Our Telegram is thriving. We do weekly dev We do a weekly dev live stream. In fact, we live stream the entire Polygon migration, including showing the actual code. It was a 7-hour migration, and you can watch it. It's on our YouTube channel because we wanted to bring the whole community to this. We had fun. We made jokes. We hang out. We do Axion Fridays, which is just a community hangout. We do Monday hangout. Like it's like I said, it's like a club. It's a club of like-minded investors who believe in the long-term power, the long-term staying power of crypto, the long-term gains, you know, that sort of generating that long-term wealth is really what is a powerful uniter for our community. You know, there are a lot of communities out there who have investors come in and they're all really excited, and then kind of some of the things die out and they all disappear, right? And they move on for what's the next big thing. People in our community, of course, are out there looking for the next big thing. It's crypto. We all doing that. But they keep coming back to Axion and just be like, man, you guys are so awesome. I love hanging out with you all. And that's really cool. You know, crypto is, it's sometimes a little bit easy to forget about the people on the other side of these wallets, right? The people who are buying and selling. With Axion, it's really hard to do that because we see the people in there every day. We see the community talking, coming up with ideas, making proposals, wanting to join in our town halls, all that sort of stuff. And they keep coming back. And that lets us know as a project that there really is something special. Otherwise, it would have disappeared. I mean, like I said, we're a year old. We've been around for over a year now. The fact that we're still around, we survived Ethereum gas fees, we're still innovating, the project is still thriving. You know, to me, that just shows that there really is something special. And now all it takes is you guys to come and find and discover the project and be a part of it and tell other people. It really is. I mean, you know, every crypto project believes they're the next undiscovered gem. But I really do think that Axion is special and that there's something about it that makes it different from a lot of these other projects. And that really is just the power of our community. So if you're interested in Axion, you want to check it out, you're going to be welcomed in with open hands by a lot of like-minded people who see the long-term benefits of crypto and want to go along for the ride.
I think you're speaking to our community. I think our community will love this project and I'm sure that they'll get involved. I've never seen a project where invest in my life, and I've been investing in the investing space for over 14 years. I've never seen a project where people are investing for 15 years.
It's insane. Ever. It's absolutely insane.
Like 5 years is a long time. Mm-hmm. And I see GICs and stuff like that where it's 5 years. And I don't even want to go near that because it seems like it's so long.
It does.
15 years in crypto is like 100 years. So it's mind-boggling to think that people would actually stake their coins, hold their coins for 15 years. But it goes to show that investors see the forest through the trees. They see the potential and they say, okay, this is a cheap coin right now. Mm-hmm. But in 15 years, what is it going to look like? Yeah. I mean, we've seen what Bitcoin's done in 10 years.
Yeah.
You know, we've seen what Ethereum's done over the last few years. We've seen what Doge has done in a year. So imagine what Axion could do. So in saying that, what is the best way for investors to get in touch with the company or the project if they have any questions?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you can go to axion.network. Oh, that's our domain. It's not axion.com. It's .network. Fancy URLs. And you can find all the information about our project. We have a vibrant Discord community, just discord.gg/axion. Vibrant Telegram community, same thing, t.co/axion, I believe. And any questions that you have, like I said, we have that support button. So if you click on our staking portal, if you go to our homepage, you'll see that blue circle that says help. And you can literally start a live chat with our support team who's available 24/7 to answer your questions, that sort of thing. I'm on there. In fact, while we were talking, I've had a couple of support things that have pinged in. So that means when I'm done with this, I'm going to go help people out. That really is kind of the thing that's I already talked about that makes it so powerful, is that community. Taking care of the community is the most important thing for us. And so, yeah, come visit our website. Our staking portal is gorgeous. The accelerator looks really cool. The collider is awesome. When you load NFTs, there's a whole cool animation that happens. There's some Easter eggs on our site that are really fun. You know, we're a really cool project that has its hands open to you guys. And it kind of, as you mentioned, right? Like there is a huge potential for people to get in. The price is really great. I think we're very undervalued right now. And it's exciting to see what will happen as we have all of these features and get lifted up. And the cool thing is, for these people who've staked for this 15-year mark, you know, they aren't losing out. It's not like they go away and they show up in 15 years. The entire time they're earning Bitcoin dividends, Axion launches, voting on stuff, the new collider features, the NFT ecosystem that we've got going. You're not just left out to dry for 15 years. And you can see all of that on our website, the plan, check out our roadmap, all that sort of stuff. Come in and talk to us. We're always around. Yeah, I don't know what else there is to say. Come check it out.
I think that you've covered it all. And thank you so much for your time today.
Yeah, thank you.
I must remind everyone that Rich TV Live is strictly for information and education purposes. Please do your due diligence, do your research before you invest in anything we talk about or discuss here on Rich TV Live. In saying that, I'm very excited about this project. I do believe it's undervalued, underappreciated, underexposed. Thank you for joining us today, Joel Gerlach, the core contributor of Axion Network, to explain the project to us today. Thank you, Joel.
Thanks, man. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure.
And for those of you guys that are watching, if you're not winning, probably not watching, we bring you the winners, we bring you projects like this, and we bring them to you first. Thank you for watching, everybody. This is Rich from Rich TV Live, with Joel Gerlach, the core contributor of Axion Network, saying, have a nice day, everybody, and we'll see you soon.